from a fairy tale wedding to a full-on public feud. Turkish twist to superstar match. Nusrat claims her marriage is illegal. Ex-partner says he feels cheated. Love, legality, and dhoka. Nusrat Shadi Showdown.
A day after Trinamool Congress Member of Parliament and actor Nusrat Jehan claimed that her 2019 wedding in Turkey to businessman Nikhil Jain was not valid, the BJP accuses her now of lying in the Parliament on the floor of the House as an elected representative. Take a look at this report.
Nusrat Jehan's marriage story and her dreamy destination wedding in Turkey is now unravelling. On Wednesday, in a written statement, the actor and Trinamool MP declared that since she had gotten married to Kolkata-based businessman Nikhil Jain on foreign land and as per Turkish marriage regulations, the ceremony is invalid. She also says that since theirs was an interfaith marriage, it required validation under the Special Marriage Act in India, which never happened. So Nusrat now claims that her wedding was at best a live-in relationship. Her former partner too says he's seeking an annulment.
The civil suit that you have filed, it's for a divorce, a mutual separation?
It's for the annulment of the marriage.
It's for the annulment of the marriage that had happened in Turkey, in Turkey, right?
That's true, yeah.
While Nusrat claims that her Turkish wedding was never legal, she did throw a big reception celebrating it in Kolkata. The high-profile event was attended by West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee herself.
Assalamu alaikum, namaskar. Ami Nusrat Jehan Ruhi Jain, Lok Sabha Sadasya Nirbachito Hoiya.
In fact, as a first-time MP, Nusrat Jehan took the oath in Parliament wearing sindoor. Now the BJP has accused the Trinamool MP of lying in Parliament by putting on record that she was married to Nikhil Jain. The BJP's IT cell head Amit Malviya has tweeted to ask if Nusrat Jehan lied as an elected representative. With Nusrat Jehan announcing her split from Nikhil Jain, rumours are swirling about her alleged relationship with co-star and BJP leader Yash Das Gupta. Both have so far maintained that they're only good friends. Bureau Report, India Today.
Another twist in Nusrat Jehan and Nikhil Jain marriage saga. This after the Trinamool Congress Member of Parliament claimed that her marriage has been invalid under the Indian law because it was not registered. Nikhil Jain has now broken silence, saying that he now feels cheated over these claims. Take a look.
This was Nusrat Jehan and Nikhil Jain in 2019 in Turkey. She was a superstar who had just become an MP and he, a reputed businessman from Kolkata. But their fairy tale is now turning into a very public personal feud. While Nusrat claims that there was no marriage between her and Nikhil Jain and that it could best be described as a live-in relationship, Nikhil claims that the two lived together as husband and wife and introduced themselves as a married couple. He also alleges that he asked her to register their marriage several times, but Nusrat always avoided his requests.
How long, since when have you guys been, separated?
I mean, yeah, we've been separated.
Yeah, since?
We've been separated since November last year.
November,
yeah.
Nikhil claims that Nusrat's behavior started changing after August 2020. While she was shooting for a film with Yash Das Gupta and Mimi Chakrabarty. The war of words does not stop here. Nusrat Jehan has also accused Nikhil Jain of accessing her bank accounts illegally. She also alleged that Nikhil and his family had held back her family jewellery and other assets. Nikhil now claims that Nusrat left his apartment in November 2020 with all her personal belongings. and that it was him who transferred money into the TMC MP's account to help her repay a home loan.
Civil suit that you have filed, it's for a divorce, a mutual separation?
It's for the annulment of the marriage.
It's for the annulment of the marriage that had happened in Turkey, in Turkey, right?
That's true, yeah.
Nikhil Jain says that he feels cheated and that there is no truth in allegations leveled by Nusrat Jahan. He has now filed a civil suit against her. Bureau Report, India Today.
Just days before her wedding to businessman Nikhil Jain, Nusrat Jahan had spoken about her relationship and this in conversation with news director Rahul Kamal.
Okay.
Hi.
Hey,
so
hi,
I'm Rahul. That's Rahul, Rahul, that's Nikhil. And yes, we're getting married in the next, what, like 7, 8 days?
7 days, yeah.
Wow, congratulations.
Thank you.
Big moment, very exciting time in anyone's life.
Yeah.
I don't know, I'm working and he's working. I don't know, where is the excitement? I want to feel like a bride. I was just complaining to him yesterday only. I said, I don't feel like a bride right now. There's so much of work which is to be done.
Yeah, because we're planning everything and then we want the best to happen, so we just don't want anything to go wrong.
So how do you guys meet? Tell us about this love story.
So we knew each other for 3 years. I have a brand, Rangoli, and she was my brand ambassador.
Aha,
for the brand.
Nice, well
that's,
done there.
That's how we met, so, and we got along as friends, and then we started dating.
No, don't lie, we were never friends in the first 2 years.
Yeah.
And later we became friends.
He was a
friends.
Paycheck of sorts, initially.
No, I always deal with my clients like clients. So I've never gone out for a coffee with him. You can never say that. I've never gone for any kind of date or dinner with my client.
So you are very professional.
From a client, yes.
So how did a brand ambassador go from being someone you give a paycheck to someone you get married?
Well, I mean, it's just like when you meet someone and you feel the aura of that person. So I really liked her aura and the way is her personality. So I wanted to know her as a more than a in a professional capacity.
I think for me, I was getting old. I should have got married. My mother was bothering me way too much.
So Nikhil, Nusrat's just become a MP.
Yeah.
Is that a good thing from your perspective? Is that a bad thing from your perspective?
Oh, I'm really like elated because this was the best thing that could have happened.
How is it the best thing? You know, it's a big intrusion into somebody's private space.
Yeah, but I would, like we've always had discussions, like, you know, how would life be after this? And I always told her that, you know, whatever you are happy in, you know, at the end of the day, if she is getting what she wants in life.
So now she's all coy, and, you know, earlier she's very confident in strutting around.
No, because I really want her to get everything in life.
So you guys are aligned politically or do you have furious political disagreements?
Oh, the disagreements and agreements, we can agree to disagree sometimes and we just go like, you know, yeah, this is your view, this is my view, and we come somewhere in the middle, and that's how.
I think we're on the same page. We manage that.
We get on the same page later, like after conversation.
That means she bullies you and pulls you onto her page.
No, I don't do that. I just give him logical stuff so that, you know, he buys my words. And at the end of the day, see, I will never fight if I'm wrong, no? So if I'm right, I only fight.
And you're always right?
Yeah, that's right.
When we used to go out for chais and dinners, we used to be just the two of us. Now we have an entire family of our cops following us as well. It's little weird at times. We're slowly trying to get used to it. And I've told Nikhil, imagine they're invisible.
So this can be a very intrusive date, Nikhil, because you've got all these cop cars at the back.
No, it was in the beginning, maybe for like first couple of times we went, but now they're all family, you know. So
are you concerned, Nusrat, that a lot of the things that a young couple ordinarily likes to do, just hang out together. Now that you're an MP, there'll be a lot of scrutiny and focus and all of that?
Not really. We're getting married and it's going to be legal in a few days. And me seeing with my husband should not be anything that, you know, should bother anybody else. And, you know, in India, we really believe in a lot of ritual and culture. So I don't think there should be any kind of issue. I'm going to balance my home, my work very well.
So in legal terms, is Nusrat Jahan's marriage with Nikhil Jain illegal and invalid? As Nusrat has said that her Turkish law marriage is invalid in India. So what does the law of the land say here? Take a look at this report.
Assalamu alaikum, namaskar. Ami Nusrat Jahan Ruhi Jain.
Was it a marriage or not? Nusrat Jahan claims that her 2019 wedding to Nikhil Jain is void in India since it happened on foreign land. The TMC MP says that the union was illegal since a Turkish marriage ceremony is invalid. But what does the law say? Nusrat and Nikhil Jain got married in Turkey. Turkish marriage law states that if two foreigners of the same nationality decide to get married in Turkey, they will have to present themselves in front of the authorities from the embassy or consulate of their country in Turkey, or in front of Turkish authorities who are entitled to perform civil marriages.
तुर्की में केवल कानूनी प्रक्रिया के अंतर्गत जो किए गए सिविल विवाह हैं, उन्हीं की मान्यता है। धार्मिक आधार पर किए गए विवाहों को तुर्की का कानून नहीं मानता। यदि किसी ने तुर्की के अंदर अपना विवाह किया है और उसको पंजीकृत करवाया है, तो निश्चित रूप से उसने तुर्की के अधिकारियों के समक्ष ऐसे दस्तावेज जरूर दाखिल किए होंगे जिनसे पता चलता होगा कि उस दंपत्य का विवाह भारत में यदि होता तो बिल्कुल वैध होता।
So do Nusrat and Nikhil need a divorce in India? Since both of them are from different faiths, they had to register themselves under the Special Marriage Act. The legal registration, however, never happened. So that's why Nusrat Jahan now claims that her alleged marriage was only a live-in relationship, while Nikhil Jain has filed a civil suit seeking an annulment. Bureau Report, India Today.
The speculation is rife about a third name that has emerged with the separation. Is Bengali actor Yash Dasgupta the reason behind the split of Nusrat Jahan with Nikhil Jain? Speculation is rife that Nusrat and Yash are off-screen couples. But time and again, both of them have maintained they are just good friends and in fact even political rivals. Here is the full story.
TMC MP and Bengali superstar Nusrat Jahan's marriage mess has put the spotlight on actor Yash Dasgupta. The 35-year-old actor is allegedly romancing Nusrat since 2020. And Nusrat and Yash's alleged affair is hitting the headlines and is being touted as the possible reason for the actress's separation with her husband, Nikhil Jain. In 2016, Yash made his debut on silver screen with the Bengali film Gangster opposite Mimi Chakrabarty, who is considered Nusrat's close friend. In 2020, Dasgupta shared the screen with Nusrat Jahan in the Bengali film SOS Kolkata.
Headquarter ke inform kore do. SOS Kolkata.
Industry insiders claim that it is during the shoot of this very film that romance between the two blossomed.
We have been friends and we have been we have known each other since a very long time, and the thing is I really look up to her.
In February this year, Yash joined BJP before the Bengal elections. The decision raised eyebrows since his political ideology was completely opposite to his rumored love interest. Speaking to India Today, the actor defended the differences in political opinion, saying that even family members think differently.
Do you discuss politics with her?
Not really. Even being in a single family, okay, it's you can have different political ideologies.
With Nikhil and Nusrat's separation now official, the rumor mills are abuzz that the Bengali superstar is allegedly pregnant. Amid these rumors, Nusrat dropped a cryptic post on her Instagram story, which reads, "You will blossom in your way." However, the actress did not give any explanation. While Yash and Nusrat's relationship is grabbing the headlines, the two maintain that they are just friends. Bureau Report, India Today.
Nusrat Jahan and Nikhil Jain wedding saga has created a lot of buzz in Bengal. Bengal BJP Chief Dilip Ghosh has now also come forth with a controversial and even a derogatory statement. He's called Nusrat Jahan a fraud. Referring to the TMC MP, Ghosh has said that she wore sindoor. People are also then now claiming to be unmarried after having spoken on the floor of the house. Ghosha slammed Nusrat Jahan for taking oath in the parliament as a married woman and has even further attacked her, saying that a person who was given a ticket by the TMC took oath as a married woman now says she's not even married. He's asking, how did Mamata Banerjee go to a wedding reception when the person is not even married by law?
কত বড় ফ্রড একজন এমপি পার্লামেন্টে যিনি সদস্য হয়েছেন তাকে ক্যান্ডিডেট করেছে টিএমসির মতো পার্টি তিনি বলছে আমার বিয়েই হয়নি অজ সিঁদুরের ফোঁটা লাগিয়ে বোকা বানিয়ে পুজো উদ্বোধন করে রথ টেনে ভোট নিয়ে জিতে গেলেন যার বিয়েই হলো না তার নিমন্ত্রণটা মমতা ব্যানার্জি কী করে খেলেন কত বড় ফ্রড চলছে বিয়ে না করে সিঁদুর পরে তার বাচ্চাও হয়ে যাচ্ছে কত নিচে নামবে আমাদের বাংলা রাজনীতি আর এমপির মতো একজন ক্যান্ডিডেট কাকে করা হচ্ছে 2.5 লাখ ভোটে তারা জিতেছে কতবার মানুষকে ধোকা দেওয়া হবে
That's a wrap on this bulletin. For further news and updates, you can always log on to indiatoday.in or download the application on your phones. But stay tuned. Thank you for watching.